everybody. I'm Jimmy Driftwood, and I want to welcome you to the Ozark Folk Center in Mountain View, Arkansas. Now, for the next few minutes, why don't you just sit back and take a relaxed tour of one of the most unique places in this world. Folks, you're going to see things that you either never have seen in your lives, or at least you never have seen in a long, long time. And you're going to hear some old-time ways of making music before you leave this hill, like you possibly would never hear anywhere else in the world. You know, the first place, if you're a tourist and coming in, the first place you're going to stop, perhaps, is down at the lodge, because that's where you're going to rent your room. Just outside the window of that is a very beautiful swimming pool. You've got the forest all around you. In this part of the country, you can let it come a shower of rain in the hot summertime, and immediately those leaves begin to put out more, throw off more oxygen and take in more of the carbon dioxide, and you've got something good to breathe. So our motel units are in the places where you've got good air to breathe. Farther on than that is the one beautiful restaurant over there where you can just get any kind of a big meal you want. And anybody that ever goes in our restaurant on this hill, I guarantee you he'll want to go back again. If he ever comes back to this town, he'll go there again. Now, I live 12 miles out, but I come in many a day just to go over to that beautiful restaurant where you can see way off in the distance Blue Mountain over here, which is a part of the Ozark Mountains, the big rocks out behind the restaurant. And of course, you know, they've got a man over there that knows how to get some good meals prepared. And then you can just travel all over the hill and see whatever you want to. And if you get thirsty, there's a place where you can get a drink and some ice cream. Farther on is there's a big building where all the offices are. That's where we teach the classes in folklore. There are conference rooms of about any size one might want. I believe the little auditorium over there holds about 150 people, something like that. Nice seats, a stage, blackboards, place to show TV, programs or slides if you want to do it. The offices are in the same building. Of course, there's the lobby. It's spacious, too. Away low down in Scarlet Town, young William lay a dying. They sent our runner to Stony Town after Barbary Ellen. Barbary Ellen is a long, long old folk song. Been around hundreds and hundreds of years. And it's just one of the many, many British ballads that this entire country is full of. In fact, I think there are more of the old British ballads in the Ozarks than anywhere. And this is a part of our heritage. Of course, we teach classes in folklore here. We will teach the music, the dance, the crafts, and all types of things that go with the heritage of this country. We're trying not only to preserve the heritage and sit it up on a shelf somewhere in a bottle, but we're trying to keep it alive with live people that keeps doing this sort of thing. And then, of course, from the old British ballads and the old dances and the early American folk songs, we come right on down to Civil War songs, bad man songs, you know, like Jesse James and Cole Younger and all that sort of thing. But our music has been very important to us, and I'll tell you why it stayed here more than it went somewhere else. We were isolated in this country because right in this part of the Ozarks, we didn't get roads. I can remember well when Sid McMath, God, I wonder how long that's been, put the first gravel road through this town. Did you know when I was a boy, if you went anywhere, you either had to walk, ride a horse or a mule, or ride an old ox or a mule wagon. That's the only way you could go. So we didn't go very far. But I think sometimes we went further than we do today. I heard an old man say the other day, he said to me, he said, Jimmy, I've got some friends at Mountain Home. That's about 40 miles away. He said, 20 and 25 years ago, we got in our wagon every year, and we drove up there to see them. I've had a car for 10 years, and I ain't seen them since. Now, did you know there's a lot to that? Isn't it funny that the faster we go, the longer it takes us to get somewhere, it seems, doesn't it? Well, we were talking about the music of this. I get with a bunch of people like you are, and you know, I like to talk about these old things. Anyhow, now, the music, of course, is played every day, 6 days a week here in this little building. There's somebody there every day playing music, just try to help out. Then, of course, at night, just back of us here is the big auditorium where we have the programs every night.
I read in a magazine the other day where it said if you didn't expect anything, you wouldn't get disappointed, so...
I'm sure you notice that when these people are dancing, no two of them are doing the same thing. This is the Ozark jig dance they're doing. And sometimes people come up and they say, can you teach us how to jig dance? Well, you know, if you want to get in there and watch somebody else do exactly his steps, all right. But if you want to do it the real way, just get on the stage and let the music start. And start doing your own way, and maybe your own personality will come out through your feet. Maybe so. What I'm going to try to do, I'm going to try to play a leaf off of a hickory tree. I think that a leaf off a tree was the first instrument that anybody ever played, and they're sort of, it's been dry, and they're not in the best shape in the world. I just run out and gathered a handful. Let's try one. To flay a leaf, you just fold it a tiny bit. And it must not break. It must have resiliency and push back. And the leaf will become the reed and the person will become the instrument. Let's see. You know, I told you a while ago that I thought the first instrument that a man ever played was the leaf, and I do. And I think the first man-made instrument that he ever played was the bow that he hunted with. To play a bow, you strum a string like this. Work your mouth like this. Did anybody laugh? Yeah. Okay, fine. Now, let's see if I... Now, let me tell you what happens when you... Strum the string, a vibration starts and goes right through that wood. And if you touch it to your cheek, that vibration will go through your cheek, and whatever shape you make your mouth cavity inside, that's the note that will come out. Let's try it. Well, you know, as I said before, that's what these buildings were built for, was to not only preserve, but to keep alive the old things that our forefathers did in the past. I think maybe they'll let me come out one more time in a while. Thank you.
I'm going to try to sing you a little song if I can keep from coughing. My gal, she wanted me to go down to the confectionery the other day and get her some sorghum lice and flapjacks. So I went down there and didn't have nothing to give me but my old hat. Started back down the road, I felt something coming cold down the side of my face, and I just tuck it in. It's good, it's molasses. Went on down the road a piece further and felt something coming cold down the other side of my face, but I didn't take it in. It was a fly. I went to see my gal the other night, and I told her I was going to kiss her goodnight. The old man heard me, and he said we'd play a game of cards to see whether I kissed his gal goodnight or not. So we went in and sat down, and the old man dealt and clubbed his trump. And of course, I was a-begging. He gave me one right over the head. I went out the back door, and I come around with the window shoot and stuck her head out the window. Says, I'll be at home next Sunday, Dick. I said, yes, gosh, and I will, too.
Tonight we have Aunt Ollie Gilbert, and Aunt Ollie can sing you 500 old songs and never look at a note. This is something. I never knew of a mind like hers. Aunt Ollie? Aunt Ollie's 83.
It rained a mist, it rained all day. Two little boys went out to play. Went out on the grass to play. Went out on the grass to play. The first ball tossed. It was too high. The next one was too low. The next one was in a jewel's room where no one is allowed to go. Where no one is allowed to go.
Friend Mona Jones.
I think probably the thing I like most about being down here, excuse me, Bill. This is Bill Dom. I think everybody knows who he is anyway. He's going to back me up on a fiddle tune, but the thing I like most about being down here are the old fiddle tunes and the old songs I hear and learn, because I love them. I've been trying to play the fiddle for several years now. I won't tell you how many, but anyway, I do hear a lot of old-time songs down here that I never hear anywhere else. I'm going to do one now that I learned from my daddy a long time ago. He was an old-time fiddler called Bile of Cabbage Down.
Grandpa Jones.
I've heard a bill, got a steel on the hill where a toll McGallan heard you. Ordered in the sky, get the drunk, they take five. From the minute that girl down there. Whoa! That toll down the hill. And they have every few times.
Let me do this song that I did for no other reason, put it together for no other reason than to teach a class in school. That was back before I'd even finished college or anything like that, but I was a teacher. And I thought then that I was doing something just to help the kids learn. And you know, I went to college after that, and I found out in college that they have a term for that sort of thing. It's called enriching the curriculum. Yeah.
Well, in 1814, we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon and we took a little beans. We met the bloody British near the town of New Orleans. Fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't nigh as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began to run it down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. I seen Mar Jackson walking down the street, talking to a pirate by the name of Gene Lafitte. He gave Gene a drink that he brought from Tennessee, and the pirate said he'd help us drive the British in the sea. Oh, the French said, Andrew, you'd better run. The Pakenhams are coming with a bullet in his gun. Oh, heck, we said he didn't give a damn. He's gonna whip the britches off of Colonel Pakenham. Fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't nigh as many as it was a while ago. We fired once more and now they began to run down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. We looked down the river and we see the British come, and there must have been 100 of them beating on the drum. They stepped so high and they made the bugles ring, while we stood beside our cotton bales and didn't say a thing. Old Hickory said we could take them by surprise if we didn't fire a musket till we looked them in the eyes. We held our fire till we see their faces well, opened up our squirrel guns and really gave them hell. We fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and now they began to run down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Well, we fired our cannon till the barrel melted down, so we grabbed the alligator and we fought another round. Filled his head with cannonballs and powdered his behind. When we took the powder off, the gator lost his mind. We'll march back home, but we'll never be content till we make old Hickory the people's president. And every time we think about the bacon and the beans, we think about the fun we had back down in New Orleans. We fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. Fired once more and now they began to run down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Well, they ran through the bars and they ran through the brambles and they ran through the bushes where a rat couldn't go. Ran so fast the hounds couldn't catch them down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. We fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't nigh as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and now they began to run down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico.
Thank you so much.
Each April and each October, we have a folk festival at Mountain View. And of course there are, well, thousands of people come to the folk festival. And, to show you something about the crowds, one year we had 103,000 cars. That isn't bad at all, of course, for a little town of 1,500 people. Sometime during the festival, we move the big show out to the outside part of the auditorium, where a lot more people can see, and they can be in the open air, too, you know. Now, a lot of the people that come to the folks there bring their own lunch. Bring a basket lunch or however they want to. But if you don't have your own lunch, there is a place close by where you can get sandwiches or what have you. At the place where you get your hamburgers and so forth, there's plenty of ice cream. But I'll tell you what, if you get some, you better establish ownership pretty soon. Oh, yes, and then there's plenty of Adam's Ale. You can get a drink of water if you'd like to, if you're up to it, of course. Since we use the word up to it, a lot of people like to try to walk on the stilts. Now, we call them Tom Walkers. There are some people who actually fall in love for trying to walk on the Tom Walkers, but some people just, well, they just fall off. Yes, I should say that a seat on top of Daddy's shoulder is a much safer way. A lot of the visitors who come to the Folk Center, they like to see where this whole thing began. So they take a side trip over to the Court Square. Now with the crowds that we have during the festivals, of course there's music and there's jig dancing. Well, all over the community, all over Folk Center USA,
For instance, up at the Uptown Theater in Mountain View, there's Jimmy Driftwood and the Rack and Sack people. And over at the Fairgrounds, there is the Saturday night group who call themselves the Mountain View Folklore Society. And on the court square, there's just everybody having a great time. Any time, of course, that there's fast music in the Ozarks, especially at the festival, there's going to be jig dancing. And you'll notice that this jig dancing is not just by the Ozarkers. You may have people from San Francisco to New York doing the same thing. One thing sure, that when they do get started, they really cut a mean rug. I told you at the beginning of this show that you was going to see a lot of things that you've never seen before. I guess you can say that you've seen them now. But there's one thing for sure, you really haven't ever seen them till you have seen it in person. Believe me when I tell you that Mountain View is the place to get away. Ozarks and Mountain View is a natural. Come on up and join us.